It's happening. It is actually happening. In two of my recent videos, I revealed that President Trump is making a play for New Jersey and New York. Well, actions speak louder than words. President Trump has just announced a rally in the Bronx. That's right. President Trump is hosting a rally in the belly of the beast, Deep Blue, New York City. They're keeping him off the campaign trail, so he is bringing the campaign trail to them. After the success of his massive New Jersey rally, Trump announced the Bronx rally right outside of the courtroom, where he also revealed another rally in Madison Square Garden is being planned.
And I think we have a good chance of winning New York. We're going to give it a big plan. We're going to the South Bronx to do a rally. We're going to be doing a rally at Madison Square Garden, we believe. We think we're signing Madison Square Garden to do it. We're going to have a big rally.
The New York Times is confirming the rally, though of course they are minimizing it by simply calling it an event that is taking place next Thursday. After he announced the rally, Trump went deep into New York City to do some retail politics, where he revealed his messaging strategy to the media.
And we're going to come into New York. We're making a big play for New York. Other cities too, but this city, I love this city. And it's gone so bad in the last 3 years, 4 years, and we're going to straighten New York out. So running for president, we're putting a big hit on New York. We think we can win New York with 500,000 migrants that poured in and take over the parks. They took over your hotels. They take over everything. It's no good. And you know what they've done? They've destroyed so many people. The African-American community now is not getting jobs. Migrants are taking their jobs that are here illegally. Hispanics are not getting jobs. Migrants are taking the jobs.
Now, of course, all of this raises the question, how can President Trump win New York State, let alone the city, which is as blue as they come? Well, it turns out that Trump is making inroads with black voters. Take a look at this clip.
If President Trump came here to the South Bronx, would you attend the rally?
Of course. I would want to meet Trump. I would want to shake his hand.
He's the only president that I see that can ever make America great again. He's capable of doing that.
I would love to go to a rally with Donald Trump come, because I'm a big Donald Trump supporter, and I will support him 100%.
Oh, yeah, definitely we're going to show him love. We're going to show him a lot of love, and, you know, like they do in other states. We definitely need to see Trump here.
There's nothing but love for Donald Trump here in the South Bronx, the North Bronx, the East Bronx, and the West Bronx.
So, you tell me.
We want Trump to come back. Please, bro. Biden, get out of here, bro.
I would come to the rally and support Trump, because the Bronx need a change, and we need somebody that's really going to help this community.
I would definitely come to a Trump rally in the South Bronx. I like him.
You do?
Yes.
Yes, I will come to a rally if President Trump was to come to the Bronx, and I also would bring other people to come too and support him.
Would Joe Biden get a warm reception if he came to the Bronx?
No, he wouldn't have, and I'll make sure of that.
Here's the thing, though. Even though I like Newsmax and think they're just fine, we all know how the media works. They can cherry-pick their clips to air on their network. So even though we saw all those black voters saying they're excited for President Trump to come to the Bronx, we don't know if that's actually truly representative of the majority of people on the ground, or if those voters were just the needles in a haystack. Like, were those the only people they interviewed, or did they interview 1,000 people just to find a few pro-Trump voices in New York? Well, the poll suggests that President Trump could make history with black voters. Take a look at what pollster Frank Luntz told CNN.
But specifically with black voters, it's not all black voters, it's younger black voters, and particularly younger black men. I discovered this when I got off a plane at JFK, when two baggage handlers came over to me to tell me that I don't get it, that they're gonna vote for Donald Trump because they think they are being victimized the same way that he is. In some of these votes that have left Joe Biden over the last 4 years, it's because of Biden's weakness. In this case, young black men see in Donald Trump the same kind of oppression, the same kind of persecution, the idea that Trump is a victim and they feel victimized by the system. And so they're endorsing Trump because of the fight that he's having. And I actually think it's possible that among black voters, male black voters under age 40, that even a third of them could end up with Trump in the fall.
Here's the irony. All the talk about systemic racism and systemic oppression can actually backfire on the Democrats. I think a lot of people are seeing these sham trials against President Trump. Trials that could have been brought any time over the last 4 years, but coincidentally, were only announced after he started running for president. You see, grassroots Republicans and conservatives use a different word. We say it's the establishment against President Trump. Well, I'd like to ask this question. Do black voters view what we call the establishment as the system being against President Trump? Because if so, then Trump's message could really resonate against them. Instead of anti-establishment, it's anti-system. And of course, the irony is that it was the Democrats who started all this talk about systemic oppression. In other words, maybe we've all been talking about the same thing, but have just been using different words. CNN even admits that Trump's black support has already over doubled. And keep in mind, we're still very early in the campaign.
But look at this number for Donald Trump, 22%. Where was Donald Trump at this point 4 years ago in the polls? He was just at 9% of the vote. So he's seen more than a doubling in his support among African Americans. This margin, which was in the 70s just 4 years ago, look at where it is now, 69 minus 22. That puts it in the 40s. My goodness gracious, if this held through the general election, obviously we're still months away, this would be by far the best performance for a Republican candidate among black voters in a generation, two generations, probably since 1960 and Richard Nixon against John F. Kennedy. That's how long we're really talking about when we're looking at this margin here. This could be a truly historic margin. It's quite a troubling sign for the Biden campaign.
This really got me to thinking, this proves how honest Trump is. Look, I think he's terrible when it comes to specifics and details. No one can argue that. But when it comes to the big picture, he's always been consistent. He's always said that he's for all Americans. He's always said that what he's done is for the entire country. Well, all Americans means all Americans. Republicans always write off New York and all these deep blue states, but being a leader means being able to think outside the box, being able to redraw these lines. I think that by playing for New York, Trump is not just trying to broaden his base, but broaden the tent of the entire party. And isn't that a good thing? I think Vivek Ramaswamy said it best.
Republicans are finally showing up in places that we should have been for a long time. The last time a Republican for president went to the South Bronx was actually Ronald Reagan in 1980, yeah. And that made a big difference then. I think we can have a 1980-1984 style Reagan outcome this year. And I think it's fantastic that President Trump is going to the South Bronx, not putting on theatrics like Joe Biden is doing, trying to check boxes, but authentically actually speaking to voters. America First includes all Americans. I'm talking to you tonight from Chicago. During my own campaign, I visited the South Side of Chicago, Jesse. And there were more voters there who agreed with me on topics ranging from cutting off foreign aid that doesn't advance U.S. interests in places like Ukraine, all the way to sealing our own southern border. So I think these historical lines that the media has drawn, that the Democratic Party has drawn, trying to pit black against white, or man against woman, or gay against straight, or even Democrat against Republican, those are false boundaries. When you have an America First movement now, that's, I dare say, reuniting this country. And that's what Donald Trump is going to deliver.
But of course, that is just my analysis, and I would love to hear yours in the comments below. Do you think President Trump actually stands a chance in New York, or is this just a pipe dream? Why or why not? If you haven't already, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. I know it's a simple thing to ask, but it really helps me reach more viewers like you in the algorithm. Smash that subscribe button as well as the notification bell, and be sure to check out one of these videos.